Living every day, laughing every moment, and loving beyond words with family and friends, that's what life's all about.
About that, I'm too bad. The boy got saved and I got a new swag. You didn't know about me.
I love to cook, I love to entertain, and I love living my life as I know it.
I'm on that new life, sipping that spirit that'll get you so right. He ain't on
maybe
about
you
me.
Didn't know that I rock Christ in my life when I spit the flow. That I rock nice on the mic with the lyrical. Boy, I rock right so they might get the spirit.
Yes, it is another Cooking with Soul episode right here on Life as I Know It. You guys, today we're going to make some Southern chicken fried steak with Southern gravy. Chicken fried steak? Yeah, let's go ahead and get started. All right, we got here, you know I already prepped myself, but I'm here to let you know the ingredients that I have for you on today for my flouring. Here is some onion powders that I've used. I also, have is all-purpose flour, and everything will be below in the information box. Here is some cayenne pepper. I love cayenne pepper. Smoked paprika. I love the smell of smoked paprika, you guys. Also, I seasoned it with some fresh cracked black pepper and some salt also. And what else do we have here? Nothing, but we're going to go ahead and get the stirring and mixing it up and whisking it together. I have a fork here, you all. I couldn't find my whisk until later on, so it is what it is. It got the job done. You see, you got the job done. Next, we're going to make our egg mixture because we're going to do a little station or whatever with our steak. And so now I'm using, putting a little bit of water in here, and then I'm mixing one egg together. And then we're going to use that as part of our process of coating the cube steak that I have. We're going to flour it, and then we're going to put it in the egg wash. But you're going to see that in just a minute, like right now. Come on, let's go. Next, you guys, here's my station. I have my cube steak, and then I have my flour mixture, and then I have the egg mixture on the far right, as you can see. And here is the cube steak. You guys, I seasoned these already, and, you know, seasoned with black pepper, salt, and I forgot something else. I'm not for sure, but I know I did with black pepper and salt. Both sides, and as you can see, I am getting some of that excess black pepper that's on there. And then what we're going to do is, like I said, we're going to flour both sides. Both sides, excuse me, I'm getting a little tongue tied here, and then I'm going to put it in the egg wash and show y'all what we're going to do next as well with that. So flour both sides of your cube steak. You can use whatever steak you use, flank steak, I believe, but I'm using cube steak. And then you're gonna season it, flour it, egg wash, flour it again, and then put it to the side until all your meat has been done in that process as well. And so next we're gonna transfer over to the pan, and in this pan, you guys, I've already prepped it as well, and I put some oil, and again, everything measurements and everything below is going to be in the information box. I already put some oil in here and 3 tablespoons of butter, and gonna let it get hot, and then you're gonna cook the both of your cube steaks on both sides until it's done. I don't know why my transition is off a little bit, but hey, it is what it is. We got these done, and I'm doing it both sides, and I lost a clip, y'all. After it got done, I lost 2 clips, this one and the one to the end, and I'll talk about that. And so next, you guys, right here, we're going to go ahead and make our gravy. And I have I think it's 2 or 3 tablespoons of butter, and here's my flour. This is another batch of flour, not the flour that I use. I'm not that nasty, y'all. We clean around here. And making our mixture here, there's the flour. We got to use flour, chicken stock, butter and milk and salt and black pepper. And so, hey, this is what I'm making the paste here, and it's going to get all brown and golden, and you're going to see that in just a minute. And then next, after all I do that, we're going to go ahead and add our chicken stock. So y'all, I don't know why, y'all know here on Life as I Know It that I haven't cooked in a while. I don't know why, y'all. I just had this urge to cook. And as y'all can see, what I've been doing, and tomorrow I'm making another Life as I Know It meal. So I love it. Me adding the chicken stock, and then I'm going to add that as well as, you know, adding the milk a little later on. So add your chicken stock, and then, you know, continue to whisk it. Continue to, you know, this you got to pay attention to, because you don't want your gravy to burn, and you don't want, you know, nothing to get stuck on the pan, and you want everything to be just right, y'all. When I made this and wrote this recipe, I was like, okay, I done got the gravy down pat, because y'all, I cannot make no gravy to save my life. And here go, the gravy already thickened, and not really already thickened, but it's getting thick. And then next we're going to go ahead and add in our milk to kind of thin it out, but then it's going to get thickened as well. And so that's it, you guys. That's all I have for you all. And as you can see, my plate here, it looks so good. But anyway, you guys, know that I love you for real, and always remember to live every day, laugh every moment, and love beyond words. I see you on the next episode of Life as I Know It, be it the cooking with soul, my vlogging, whatever. I'm back. See y'all. Peace.